Jane, you should have called me.
No, I'm only getting better if I force the issue. Yeah. The only way not to be left to drown again is if I double my determination and my physical therapy.
Can I at least get you a cup of coffee?
Maybe some orange juice. Thank you. Thanks for staying last night, Jake. And for saving my life.
No big deal.
It was to me. Thanks. Jake, I almost died out there last night. But after you pulled me out, I realized that it wasn't Sydney's fault.
Right. She only left you out there to drown, Jane.
No, she just couldn't stand being my caretaker. No one should have to be. I have to be able to rely on myself, alone.
That's all fine. But your sister's not off the hook as far as I'm concerned.
Jake, hi. I heard Jane is back.
Oh, yeah, right over there. For giving attempted murder.
What?
Never mind. He's just being overprotective. It's good to see you.
You too. I'm glad you're back in the building. I thought Sydney was taking care of you out at the beach house.
Oh, she did that all right. That wheelchair is better than cement shoes. Well, if it isn't the fox. Welcome to the hen house.
I'm here to see Jane.
Right. You should probably search her for weapons first.
Jake, let her in.
I brought you these, hoping there was no hard feelings about last night.
That's sweet, Sydney. Thank you.
What exactly happened?
In a nutshell, Sydney was trying to get lucky last night, so she threw her crippled sister into the ocean because she was in the way.
You shut up. It was an accident. You know me, Jake. I couldn't.
What you did, didn't you?
Oh, I forgot. I'm being judged by Perfect Jake, the white knight with the IQ of a rock.
Would you guys stop it, please?
Come on, Sydney. I'll walk you out. Well, for God's sakes, I was trying to make up.